Hello and welcome back to Sportsnet Lakers, driven by your Southern California Honda dealers, Chris McGee, James Worthy, Robert Ori, Mike Bresnahan is over there. We got Allie and Trudell covering the team in the postgame. You will hear from them. Guys, the Lakers lose to the Spurs. They're unable to sweep the season series. Lakers are now 2-3 at Staples Center, and the slow start caught up with them tonight. Spurs were hot, and they stayed that way the entire game. Lakers turning the ball over five times in that first quarter. 13 for the game, James, for 16 points. Bad from the free throw line, 13 of 21.
Yeah, it'll catch up with you eventually. You know, the Lakers, their bread and butter is their defense, and they pride themselves in it. Unfortunately, you can't take it for granted. You can't think that you're going to be able to turn it on when you need it, especially against a much improved San Antonio team with Aldridge back in the lineup, a team that just came off a hot shooting game versus the Clippers. You know they're going to come in here and try to sweep two LA teams, two of the best teams in the West, just to measure where they are. And I think the last two games and tonight's game, San Antonio feels like they can play. They played well. The defense just was not ready to switch. The communication, a lot of open threes for San Antonio. And then offensively, they couldn't click because when you're not defending well, it affects your defense. Matthews couldn't hit. Kuz couldn't hit. Rushing shots, guiding shots. And, you know, San Antonio, give them credit. They played a pretty good game. They're well coached.
Came in, beat the Clippers and Lakers.
You know, that's what I was going to say about it. You know, so you're going to have these games in NBA where you come up against a team like the San Antonio Spurs. You think about this. They got two all-stars on that team, DeRozan and LaMarcus Aldridge. And then you got a gold medal winner and Rudy Gay on the bench. So this is not some team.
Patty Mills is a winner.
Yeah. This is not some team you're just going to just, you know, come out and say flip the switch on, because they have a lot of pride. They're a well-coached team, and they're a team with a lot of veteranism. And so you have to watch out for teams like this, especially going on the road, because they have something to prove, because you went into their building and lost two straight.
And remember, there was no LaMarcus Aldridge in that sweep of the Spurs on the road. Tonight, LaMarcus Aldridge plays, guys. He's stretching the floor now. He's shooting seven threes, Rob, hitting three of them. He was a matchup nightmare for Gasol, and he lit the Lakers up. 28 points, 11-18.
I think people don't realize how good this guy is. He's an all-star. You know, he's one of the guys. I think he had a record where he scored 50 points and none of them were threes. That lets you know the boy can put up some buckets. So
yeah.
He is the type of guy that can play defense, can play offense, and he's so unassuming because he plays with the Spurs. Everybody knew about him when he played with Portland, but it's amazing. But people have forgotten about him and went to the Spurs because that's what the Spurs do. They kind of lull you to sleep, and next thing you know, they're getting a dub.
No question. I remember when I was fortunate enough to be in on the meeting when the Lakers were recruiting Aldridge. You know, he didn't want to play center. That's something he didn't want to do, and I think, you know, it didn't go as well as we expected to go. But he's the kind of player that, you know, he's not like a big dominant player, like, you know, but he can shoot.
And he's always had great touch.
And when he's hitting, you know, his shot, he's almost unstoppable. We talk about how unstoppable AD is and some of the other guys, but when Aldridge is hitting shots like he can, and now he's stretched it to the three, he could be a nightmare for a defensive.
He had made only four threes entering tonight. He had three. So that's just the way it goes sometimes when you play the Lakers. We saw that with, what's his name, in Portland?
Trent.
Yes.
Yeah.
Got
Trent,
hot.
Trent Jr.
Yeah, Trent Jr. People love playing the Lakers.
Oh, we know that. Know? So listen, Spurs threes, okay? 16 of 35 tonight from three. Six guys with multiple three-pointers, eight total hit threes, big game, James. But you said something that I wrote down earlier. Slow to rotate, coverage is off, wide open threes.
Well, because, you know, Popovich is he's a genius coach. The motion that they run, the defense is going to have to react. And so it's those split seconds, those 2 or 3 seconds when you're trying to recover is where they get you. They drive, DeRozan drives, you know, they got Murray, they got Mills. Don't forget about Mills. He's a freaking nightmare. So they're well-groomed. They run their offense to the point where they make the defense give them something. So your antennas have to be up when you're playing San Antonio.
Yes, think about them is you forget also that DeJounte Murray was on the verge of being an all-star, a rookie, great rookie, and then he had an ACL injury, and now he's back and he's starting to get into form. This is a good San Antonio Spurs team. You know, I'm not going to take anything away from their win, but the Lakers did come out a little lackadaisical on defense. They didn't rotate as much, and the Spurs took advantage of that. And that's what you had to do as a professional team. When a team doesn't have the eye of the tiger, you go out there and take advantage of them.
Think the Lakers are missing KCP a little bit, that starting unit?
Yeah, they definitely missed the defensive prowess, but, you know, they would have to have a collective effort, even if they had KCP tonight. Yeah. They definitely miss his defensive, you know, ability, but collectively, I don't think it would have made a big difference with him tonight, the way San Antonio was coming at the Lakers.
Yeah, they shot the ball really well. And when you run into a team that's shooting the ball well, you got to lock in defense. You got to find, you know, this is what we miss in those shot blockers. Because when a team is shooting the ball this well from the three-point line, you say, hey, run them off the three-point line. You get out there on them. But now, there's no shot blockers
right
there.
Teams aren't scared to attack.
They're not scared to attack. They're going in. And AD can't be everywhere because, let's take it, Marc Gasol is not going to fly over and block some shots. He's just going to use his body to be in position. So they need another shot blocker. Montrez, he's going to take some charges. But when you can't, when they pull you away from that basket, there's nobody to block those shots, you know, like a Dwight and like a McGee.
When you have slow starts, guys, and you kind of count on that fourth quarter burst of LeBron and AD, and we saw it tonight, it's 89-89, you're thinking, here we go in the fourth. And it just didn't go that way. You know, the five turnovers in the first, James, kind of poor free throw shooting, guys not getting to the line. It just kind of shows you the mindset to start the game. Now, they seem to warm up and get back in it every single time because they're good. But the slow starts.
Yeah, you can't afford those. I mean, fortunately, the Lakers have enough talent and AD and LeBron that they can overcome that some nights. But you don't want to do that. You want to have maybe one or two games out of 10 where you have to depend on your star players. The rest of them, you got to have a collective effort, which the Lakers have had. But when you run up against, you know, a team like San Antonio, who a lot of people don't think they're going to, you know, go far in the playoffs this year. But what I see tonight, by the time they have a couple months under their belt, they're going to be a tough team to deal with. So you're going to have some tough games in the NBA. You're not going to win them all. You're going to have some slow starts. But the Lakers have to trend and have good habits every night. And they have to be defensively. Offensively, you know, you're not going to shoot well every night. But defensively, you got to have it every night.
And also, I think if we look at, we quietly miss out that we've been having sort of a big three, you know, throwing Dennis in there. But tonight, Dennis only had, 6 points, then 3 points or something, 4 points, my bad. And he didn't play that well. And we need him to play pretty decent, meaning getting 10-plus points, because those 10-plus points right there from him is an added advantage, because the guards, we need that from him. And his defense, it's almost funny, like, he didn't have the energy tonight either. He usually up and guarding guys full court, but we didn't see that from them either. I don't know. They all got home and just got, you know, relaxed. Yeah, tired.
Happens. All right, let's get you the highlights. Take you out to Staples Center.